Hello everybody and welcome to another Jurassic World Evolution news video. Today we have a few exciting things to talk about, a few images that have popped up recently thanks to the lovely Evolution Square, so shout out to her channel straight away. Her channel will have a link in the description below, as well as one other that reveals two new dinosaurs, which we'll discuss in a second. And also we have quick news about a new thing that is happening on Friday, which is going to be the first ever Death Diary for Jurassic World Evolution 2, which is a thing that Frontier did for Evolution 1, where they covered some of the news and stuff when the game was first coming out. Now, let's not expect too much there. We won't be getting, like, all the things we want straight away. We'll probably, like, get a little bit of gameplay footage, probably not too much. Like, maybe we'll get to see, like, how buildings are customized, because we do get to see that in one of the images, actually, and we'll discuss that one first. And also, we might get to see maybe some new species, because they've done that in the past with Evolution 1's Dev Diaries, or maybe we'll get some other things. Now, on to the images, because there's not too much to go on in the Dev Diary, except for one thing I just realized I almost forgot, and that is of the thumbnail for the live stream that will be happening on Evolution 2's channel. Now you may be thinking, what's so important about a live stream? Well. It's because of what it shows. Now it shows the usual things that we've seen in the past. We get to see the Innovation Center, the new customizable aviary, which hopefully we actually get to see that. Like, we probably won't see any of the pterosaurs that we get in the game. Probably the best we'll get is a pteranodon, because we've already seen what that looks like in the past. So that's a possibility, but I hope we get to see how it's built or something, because that'd be really cool, because I've heard that it's going to be built just like regular enclosures, except, you know, with a dome on top. So hopefully we get that. We also get to see some of the guest facilities and all that jazz, but if we look at the enclosure that's shown in this thumbnail, it shows us some interesting things. Like, we get to see some dinosaurs, of course, which, from what we can see, here's the big kicker. There are three species, possibly. One of them is obviously a Brachiosaurus, I believe, like, from what we can tell. It's the only large sauropod that we know of right now, besides Camarasaurus. But if we look, the other two species there, one of them appears to be a Hadrosaur, which you can actually see two of these guys. One of them is by the water, which is, like, standing right out. And then there's one hidden behind some trees, but you can faintly see its head. Now, there's been a lot of discussion right now going around about what this species is. And the two that I'm hearing most of all are Edmontosaurus and Corythosaurus. Now, I personally am leaning more to the Edmontosaurus because of the way it's positioned, like, especially the one that's near the water. Specifically, if we look at the way it's positioned, it's quite front-heavy as it appears to be. Now, if you compare that with Corythosaurus, we know that in the first game it was more back-heavy, like something like Parasaurolophus was. So it would walk on twos and also run on 2 feet. But for Edmontosaurus, we would see that it was like a Rhinosaurus, it would walk on all fours, but like other Hadrosaurs, it would run on two. And I think that the way it's positioned, it fits for a front-heavy Hadrosaur. It could be Corythosaurus as well. Like, the head crest looks more prominent than, like, it would on Edmontosaurus, to be honest. But it could be either one, or it could be a completely different Hadrosaur. But that's the thing I want to talk about. The other species that's by one of the Brachiosaurus, nobody's been able to tell so far. Like, it could be other Hadrosaurs as well, or it could be a smaller sauropod. We can't tell, because the way it's positioned, it's like they're both, like, right beside each other, and also the Brachiosaurus is covering up most of them, so we can't see too well. So maybe in this Dev Diary we'll get to see them a lot clearer. Who knows? We'll find out. Now, on to the images that have recently been shared. The first one we have to look at is the building customization from what we can see, which so far it's looking quite promising. Now, I do think that the buildings look a bit more dull compared to the first Evolution games, but it could be so that we get to have more reason to customize them, because maybe they could all start out like flat gray and then like we choose the colors, which if that's the case, it's really smart. Then we get to make them as bright as we want or as dull as we want. But as we can see, it has a color wheel, actually, and also a color level, which the level is of the rainbow, so like all the rainbow colors. Then we got the wheel, which is of dark and light and a bit of red. And then there's some secondary colors, I think it is. Now, the thing says secondary on the top. So what I'm thinking is that the image that we're seeing for the paint job right now is of the secondary color. So I think the pink that's being shown on the building, that's what's going to count for the building as the secondary color. And then the next tab that we see that's on the left that's not highlighted, I think is going to be the primary color. So like the rest of the building, which we could have the same colors, but it seems like we're going to have two options, maybe three actually. And oh, you can actually save colors. That's going to be a nice thing. And we get the returning Spinosaurus skull, but not one, but two on this building, and also some rock features, which I hope are placeable items. I think they'll come with the buildings as well, but I hope like on the path and also like maybe around enclosure fences, we can place these scenery items, because who doesn't want to place the full Spinosaurus skeleton on the path system? I'd love for us to be able to have that. I think it's going to be very likely because of one of the other images that are going to be shown later, which we'll get to in a little bit. The next image we have here is actually of the Amargasaurus, which, oh my god, these are gorgeous. And it gives us a first look at the customization of the Amargasaurus skins, because so far we've gotten to see like only two versions of them, like specific skin patterns, but they're all like pretty much the same. And we get to see this beautiful orange one with, ooh, that's some lovely green on the spike. So I think with the dinosaurs, actually, we're gonna get three options of skin customization. So unlike with the first game, where we just picked a rainforest or jungle, and then like boom, there's your skin. I think with this, it's gonna be similar to the buildings, actually, because they look quite different. Because if you look at both Amargasaurus, they share the same skin pattern but completely different colors, which, like, the four or three sections are the underbelly, the main layer, which for the Amargasaurus on the right, it's the brown, and then the secondary color, which is the stripe on the back and also on its around its shoulder, is the orange, and then on the third color is of the spikes, which for the left one we can see is green, but for this guy, it's a yellow-blue mixture, actually, which looks very beautiful. And we get to see some of the rock scenery as well. I don't want to miss anything out. Which, these skins already are so much of an improvement. I think with this already, they look so much better. I say that the best of these two Amargasaurus, in my opinion, is actually the one on the right. Like, I love this looking, this bright orange one, don't get me wrong. It literally drawed my eye as soon as I saw this image. I was like, whoa, what is that? But for the brown one, if we had all of our Amargasaurus like around this sort of way, I would be drawn to it because like, you see that dark flat brown, which is perfectly fine, like dull and stuff, not too fancy, which a lot of people might find annoying, but I like. But then you have this orange stripe and then the yellowish blue spikes. My eyes would literally be locking on that part and be like, whoa, it's got a dull body, but lovely spikes and that lovely stripe. It's like, it's similar to Blue the Velociraptor, actually. Like, realistically, she's a gray Velociraptor. There's no unique features about her. But then you plant that blue stripe on her, boom, she stands out like from the rest of them. Like, compared to the other raptors where, like, they stand out because they have different features of them. Blue, realistically, if she didn't have that stripe, no one would pay attention to her. That blue stripe is literally what pops her. And it's the same with this Amargasaurus, it seems. Like, for the other one, it's like, boom, it's orange bright, there you go. This one, you, like, literally are drawn to a specific part of the Amargasaurus, which is what I like. Now, also in this image, we actually get to see the icon for the Amargasaurus, like the social and all that stuff, which shows comfort, health, food, water, as it did in the first game. However, two new things that are actually showing are stamina and security rating. Now, for the security rating, I know one of the images later shows us Brachiosaurus with Triceratops, and it's highlighted on one of them, and it's classed as level 5, which I think is, like, how dangerous they are to, like, people or stuff, or, like, what level of fencing they need. So, like, for example, Brachiosaurus, since it's so big, it's probably going to need something like concrete fencing, but this, since he's so small, he'll probably need regular minor fences, but he's still dangerous. He's a number 2. So, like, probably something like a Gallimimus would probably be a number 1, and probably an Ankylosaurus or Triceratops would be probably around the middle, maybe 3 or 4, and something like Stegosaurus, which we know is very aggressive, could be level 5, and then carnivores, they're all probably going to be level 5. So, I like that, but the stamina, since we know there's going to be more dynamic combat and all that stuff, we know what to expect for this, because it's not going to be like just line up, kill something, then you're done, or like circle around each other, bite once or twice, then you're done. This is going to be much more dynamic. Like, there's going to be pack hunting, there's going to be like random movements for the fighting and all that stuff. And what could be happening is, like, say a T-Rex comes into this Amargosaurus enclosure, like say a pair of them, or a pair of Allosaurus, that's a better option. Say they start to threaten the herd of Amargosaurus. The Amargosaurus start panicking, and maybe what could happen is, like, for the stamina, what happens is, like, for the younger ones, the newer created ones, like, they run out of stamina quickly, and then, like, once they run out of stamina, they either start to fight, like, they hold their ground and face the enemy, or they keel over and, like, call it quits, because that's something that happens in real life. If an Amargosaurus or Gallimimus, like, is sprinting from a raptor, and then, like, it just runs out of stamina, like, it can't keep running, it just lies down and is like, alright, get this over with, I know I'm dead, and then you see the raptor pack, like, literally surrounded. That would be so cool to see. Wow. We get to see that there's also alphas for sauropods, which is great to see. Probably we'll get that for Gallimimus as well. Speaking of next images, the Brachiosaurus and Triceratops is actually here, which shows us the ranger outpost that gets put in the enclosure, which doesn't really camouflage too well. I gotta be honest, guys. It kind of stands out there. Gotta put it around the corner next time if you're me. We know how to do this. We've built a dozen parks before. But, oh yeah, it is highlighted on the Brachiosaurus, it seems, which shows it as an alpha again, and also missing forest. Ooh, that's unfortunate. Also, one thing that I want to talk about before we get into, like, the enclosure itself specifically, is actually the water, which you notice that there's some plants in there? Because I did immediately. Like, first of all, that water, even though this picture isn't, like, good quality, the water still looks beautiful, I gotta say. Really lifelike. And if we look at it, it shows a tall looking plant, I gotta be honest, but it's mostly submerged. Now, could this be their way of saying, hey, you're gonna have different levels of water? Because, like, we know that the water tool is gonna be very similar to the first game, except now we may have different levels, which could that mean that we'll be able to have dinosaurs swimming, or also making a Mosasaurus lagoon wherever we want on the island instead of having to have it only in the lake? The next image is again of a Amargosaurus, but specifically when you're hatching them from the enclosure. Now, it shows two of them, and it's interesting because it only says that hatching is only one dinosaur right now, and it shows the security thing, the social, which says only one, so apparently we'll only need one Amargosaurus in the enclosure. It only says one dinosaur hatching, but we can obviously see two. Now, recently, it's been announced that you'll be able to make a clutch of dinosaurs in a hatchery, and we've actually seen this already with the Amargosaurus, because in its species profile, when the hatchery is opening up, we see two of them come out, with one of them sprinting out, and then the other is walking out. Now, this is because you'll be able to, like, when you're genetically modifying the dinosaurs, you'll be able to have a clutch of them, say 5, and then, like, you'll get to pick a certain amount of which ones you want to actually have incubated. So, like, of 5, you'll be able to pick 2 T-Rexes, or of Gallimimus, you'll be able to pick all 5 of them if you want, or 4, let's say, and you'll be able to hatch multiple at once. So while it shows them 5 hatching bays, you'll be able to make like multiple in each of those crates, which is going to be really nice. We get a look actually at one of the new buildings, which is of the staff center, which apparently is going to be like Planet Zoo, which I haven't played actually, but I've heard that like you'll be able to hire and fire staff. So yeah, we'll be able to hire and fire staff, it seems, which I hope it doesn't take too much effort and stuff. Like, one thing Planet Zoo players have criticized about the game is how much time it takes for like hiring and firing and doing all the stuff for the workers and stuff, when you want to really realistically focus on like building the park and also handling the animals. You don't want to focus on just the guests. They're secondary in this game, which I'm glad they're getting more use in this game compared to the first, but I don't want to see too much, if you know what I mean. The next image actually reveals the new dinosaur, which I've actually mentioned a few times, is the Gallimimus, which has the same structure as the Jurassic Park / World versions, because they're actually the same, let's just be real. However, it shows it with a very, very white belly, which is not like the film version, so obviously that's from the skin modification, which, yeah, actually does show the modification ability that you'll be able to have. So, like, it's three layers. You'll have the underbelly, which, as you can see for the Gallimimus, is the pale white. You'll have the orange, which is like the base part. And then you'll have the brown, which is like the stripes on the back and like on the legs and the tail. And a bit on the hands, actually, which will be the third color. So like it'll be split into three parts, obviously, which looks really good. On the icon for the Gallimimus, we can again see that there's alphas for these guys. Except for this case, it actually shows us which Gallimimus is actually the alpha in the group, which apparently, according to this image, Gallimimus number 12, is the leader. This one we're seeing right now is number 18, which is only 74% comfortable, and that's because he doesn't have enough ground leaf, which probably means grassland, and enough forest, which is a little sad. And also, it shows edit environment, which obviously means that we'll be able to click on this, and like when we're seeing the dinosaurs icons, like, oh, they need this much of this and this much of that, they don't have enough of them, there we go. We don't have to like exit out then go into the search bar for like environment modifications. All we have to do is just click this edit environment and then like do it the way that it'll help with the dinosaur and be able to see if it's satisfying them or not. And the next image, oh my god, is of the coolest stegosaurus by far. Those plates, damn, they stick out. And then the nice bluish gray. And then we got that alpine one, which apparently I think has the same plates as this one. So yeah, you'll be able to change them definitely. It's definitely gonna be similar to the buildings. Probably not like to the depth. Now also with the buildings, it's been said that you'll be able to customize the inside of them, like with an aquarium, certain things like a bowling alley. I'm not sure what other things, but it's going to be really interesting to see how much modifications on buildings you'll be able to do. And in the background, we actually get to see some of the buildings themselves, which they appear to be like the hotels, but they're different. They're shaped a little differently, it seems. But yeah, and the water again looking beautiful, and actually is showing some trees apparently in it, which actually is showing different levels, it seems. Because yeah, there's a tree right in the middle of the water, and it's part mostly submerged, actually, compared to the others, where around the end of the gyrosphere, it shows them just only part way through. So yeah, there's definitely different levels of water, it seems, in these images. There's one more image that we have here, and it is of the veterinary unit. The mobile vet unit, actually, sorry, I said that wrong. And it actually shows the building itself, which looks really cool, actually. And also, one thing that people have noticed is the path is actually has different thicknesses, such as the one that's connected to the building is actually quite thin, but the one going off, branching off of it is actually really, really fat. But that's another topic. We don't really care about that too much. But if you look at this veterinary unit, the vehicle is the one that actually was in the trailer, actually, I believe, the one that drove right by the Pseudoceratops. Now, I've heard that what happens is, like, if a dinosaur is injured or sick, the veterinary unit will actually go into the enclosure and, like, they'll either treat them in there, or if it's something even worse, like, say, if it got into a fight and then, like, it has a broken leg or something, then you'll transport it here, and it appears that in the back of the building is where you'll have it housed, because it's like all fenced up and stuff, secured. Which, if that's the case, that's going to be really cool to see. Like, if an Allosaurus has, like, got a broken leg, you'll see him, like, recovering in there. That's going to be really good. And, wow, that building looks... It looked very similar to, like, the buildings from the first game, like, the science and research buildings. But, guys, that is all the images and all of the, news that we have so far. So, remember, Friday we have the dev thing that's going on, where we'll probably see some new dinosaurs, some new gameplay... Hopefully, we'll find out. And also, we have these images. Two new confirmed species, Gallimimus and an unknown Hadrosaur, which could be Edmontosaurus or Corythosaurus. That's what we're guessing. And we get to see all of these, the building customization. And, oh yeah, one more thing. On this veterinary unit thing, we get to see the sidebar, which was from the first game. And we get to see all the icons, which we get the usual enclosure, viewing, buildings and stuff. Plants and stuff, but at the bottom, two of them have stuck out, and that's the last third one underneath the power supply, which shows sort of a fountain, it appears, which obviously could be like the decorations. So maybe we will get to place decorations like fountains, benches, the Spinosaurus skeleton. Please let me place that. I want to have a T-Rex smash it. And the other one underneath appears to be the Mosasaurus, actually. It shows an aquatic reptile of some sort above a plus and minus. So could that be the water, actually? I think that's actually it. Maybe we'll be able to place the water, and then what we'll do is, like, with this icon, we'll be able to shrink it or increase the level. So, like, that'll be so cool. So, yeah, I think we will be able to have Mosasaurus with... in place in man-made water. That's going to be really good. So yeah, there we go. Last thing, just before we were about to call off. Whew, glad I didn't miss that. But guys, if you've enjoyed this video, I appreciate the like, and if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button to join the hunt. Be safe, and until next time, I'll see you later. Bye-bye!